And so looking at SharePoint 2016 and what's coming, EPC Group and myself as well within the team have we've been testing 2016 for quite some time, and I want to go over some key features of 2016 so that you understand what's coming and what you can be prepared for. 2016 will support files up to 10 gigabytes. It's configurable per web application. It now will support many special characters, issues that, again, previous versions have had. SharePoint Designer 2013 and InfoPath 2013 does not ship with Office 2016. You can have some forward compatibility with those applications, but I would not recommend installing or utilizing SharePoint Designer 2003 or InfoPath 2003 with SharePoint 2016 at all, or for that matter, for Office 365 or SharePoint Online. They've actually made InfoPath free, and they've done that for a reason, because it's going to completely, they're changing that entire model. So again, to stay away from those two elements or those two applications when you're looking at, again, what 2016 and what's coming. Pretty much say goodbye to the single server install, and it will require at least two servers now, the front end and the SQL Server. There is a new durable links feature, and again, when you they've had this in 2013 to some extent, but it wasn't to the level it needed to be. This is the new feature of durable links, where you can move content, you can migrate within the application itself, and that link will really have the permalink type concept of 2013. The new durable links feature will ensure that links do not break as they're moved. Also, 2016 will now allow you to restrict access from specific IP addresses within SharePoint, not having to configure that within IIS. So that is it's a great new tool to be able to utilize, and again, not having to go into your physical servers and your VMs to configure the IIS and the IP address mapping, or that type of things right out of the box within the interface itself. There's new to SharePoint 2016 Cloud Hybrid Search Service, and allows you to consolidate both your SharePoint 2016 on-premise and Office 365 search indexes in the cloud. So you're able to really take those massive search databases that you had, and you have kind of separate experiences, and you can now utilize this to have 365 services, be able to take your search service and manage that in the cloud. Microsoft has released a 2013 version of this. You can implement this within SharePoint 2013. There's an early release, and again, I would, if you have a test environment or a dev environment that you may have, you want to implement this to get ready for it, because this is going to be a key when it comes to search, when it comes to having content in dual environments, really understanding the cloud hybrid search service. It's a major new offering within the platform. And also, the new cloud hybrid search service supports Office Graph and Delve in the on-premise environment as well. So you're able to access some of those 365 only right now type solutions, and you can actually access them on-prem. Within 2016, there's out-of-the-box DLP, data loss prevention, has built-in capabilities for identifying PII data, PHI data, sensitive data. There's a lot of auditing reports, a lot of different areas to identify specific sensitive content. SharePoint 2016 also has an app launcher, similar to that of Office 365. So when you click on, if you've used 365 on before, when you're clicking on that nine dots in the top left, for lack of a better term, you're able to launch those apps right away and get to your different major applications there within that. So it has a kind of that same similar experience in 365. Also, you can now enforce a mini role on a specific server, whether it's a search server or a front-end web server or an application server. You can actually go in and specify, and it really governs that server, so that it only will control and it will only do what you've specified that server to do. Again, in central administration and previous versions of SharePoint, you had to really go in and you could do that within central administration, but this allows you to enforce that. So you again, you're getting more performance, and the services are being rendered properly there. SharePoint 2016 no longer comes with Excel services. is that's now going to be part of Office Online Server that's on-prem, and that supports the Office web apps. So this is fully compatible with an Office 365 hybrid configuration. But just to know, those are using Excel services. You can upgrade it from 2013 to 2016, but you will need to implement an Office Online Server component to then make that compatible. SharePoint 2016 does not utilize FIM, Forefront Identity Manager. So if your network utilizes FIM and you're looking for an upgrade, it's time to start that planning now. FIM implementations can take several months sometimes. Getting all the different elements. Again, I've worked with my team members on, FIM to MIM upgrades, and again, MIM being the new identity, Microsoft Identity Manager. So with it not using FIM, SharePoint 2016 now imports users via the Active Directory import capabilities. Or again, you can optionally upgrade your Identity Manager FIM to the new MIM 2016. And within that, Active Directory import offers a performance gain for one-way imports for profiles into AD. It's a quite extensive performance gain. Also, SharePoint Foundation, really this will be the final, 2013 will be the final Foundation version release. SharePoint 2016 is not offering SharePoint Foundation, so again, that will not be offered in future releases. If your 2000 SharePoint 2013 platform or even your 2010 implementation utilizes a BCS for importing user profiles from AD, and you have some kind of synchronization set up possibly with an HR system like SAP or something similar, with the one-way sync and the Active Directory import, you'll need to rethink your architecture. So start planning for that as well. And looking at a couple other pieces, analytics have vastly improved within SharePoint 2016, really providing all those statistical, how many users have visited my site, and again, not just from a high level and having to go into each site or each sub-site and to be able to run those reports, but it offers a whole set of reports to be able to go through, looking at different levels of statistics, and again, all of those kind of reports where you had to buy a third-party tool in the past to get those reports, or you had to implement a custom solution to get those reports. 2016 comes with that out of the box. It's extremely powerful. New eDiscovery Center with compliance capabilities. It's much improved again over both 2010 and 2013. There's a new document deletion policy center that I find really useful. A couple kind of getting into the weeds technically, 10,000 site collections per content database, and also content databases can grow into terabytes, which is, I know, is very exciting for SharePoint administrators and for both also probably the database folks as well, because keeping that 200, 250, 300 gigabyte content database limitation and having to continue to create new content databases because of the DR and the site limitations, you can now grow content database into terabytes. Couple of last items, 2016 supports the new resilient file system as well as continued NTFS. And also you can now patch 2016 with zero downtime. They've decoupled the front end and back end patching. So again, you can run patches without having to perform an IS reset or anything around that. You can do it, again, you almost do it during business hours because there is a zero downtime. And lastly, Microsoft Project 2016 installs as part of SharePoint 2016. Of course, you will need the installation keys and that licensing, but they have completely brought together Project Server and SharePoint Project Server 2016 and SharePoint 2016 into the same build, and it's really becoming one and the same. Of course, it is again separate licensing, but it's quite powerful. And then just four more points here. Really, the ribbon is no longer going to be used. Really, required for frequent actions in document libraries. There is a new video improvement that allows you to hover over a video and autoplay a video. Also in 2016, it allows for external site publishing, so you can actually create a SharePoint Online site within SharePoint on-prem if you have a hybrid configuration. So you can create a new site, and you can actually point it out there and create and point to where you're creating a site. So whether it's going to be on-prem or if you want to create a site for your external vendors or external partners, you can actually provision that all within 2016 on-prem, and it will go out to 365 and SharePoint Online. And also Delve and SharePoint Search can now be configured and really integrated, so you get that Delve / SharePoint Search experience all in one. Really for this, all the social listening, all those capabilities are all rolled out into one piece. IRM, Information Rights Management, now has increased encryption. Again, I know you can ask questions, follow-up questions. We're happy to take any via email or anything after the webinar. Again, not want to get too much in the weeds, but the encryption aspect is exciting. And equally impressive are the improvements around ECM, content management, records management there as well. And that really, again, completes the overview. I'm going to just quickly go through, again, I'm the founder and CEO of EPC Group. We've topped out, I think, about 1,700 SharePoint implementations since 2001. Again, we focus a lot on 365, SharePoint side as well, and Azure, and all those different pieces. And also, just to kind of understand what maybe you have questions around the hybrid cloud, you can go to hybridcloudadvisor.com, and it really breaks down, again, different pieces, and you kind of get some education around all those different elements I talked about today. So with that, I will pass it over to Holly. And lastly, if you want to reach out to me, again, here is my email address, actually my cell phone number, and my Twitter. So again, feel free to reach out to me with any questions. And lastly, I want to mention too, Microsoft announced yesterday that SharePoint 2016 Beta 2 will be released by November 26th. So it'll have 99% of the RTM functionality. So before right around Thanksgiving here in the States, but November 26th, the Beta 2 will be released. Jeff Tepper announced that yesterday. So that's exciting. And